Welcome to this small video where I will demonstrate how Dynamics 365 for Finance and Operations Enterprise Edition works with Excel and how cost accounting data can be exported to Excel, and you can actually then create your insights using the Excel and Power PIVOT in Excel. So I'm looking at the demo data that will be shipped with the spring release. We have three legal entities. For this demonstration here, I will use the legal entity of USP2. I will not go into details of how this company is configured and explain all of the data that is there in cost accounting, as I will focus mostly on the reporting in Excel. We have two options of exporting data to Excel. If you go to the cost accounting ledger, we have under view the option of open entries in Excel, and that will take all the data of this cost accounting ledger to Excel. We also have that you can do it within the individual control units, where you only export data that is associated with this control unit. So here, if I go under view, we have the same option of open entries in Excel. In this case, I actually want to take all the data to Excel for both control units for this cost accounting ledger. So I'll go back here and go under view and click open entries in Excel. The system will ask me what data I want to export to Excel. So here I only want to look at actual cost, and I will take my cost element dimension hierarchy, and I will use my statistical dimension hierarchy here. The cost object dimension hierarchy is also taken by default for each of the control units. So here I will press open entries in Excel, and the system will actually start exporting the data when I say download. And because we have these data entities, the data will now be exported to Excel. We have two flat tables, so my hierarchies will be flattened out, and therefore I can make pivot on these in Excel. We can see that the Excel file open here. I will click open. And of course, this might take a few minutes the first time. So here I will click enable editing. And we can see here that the Microsoft Dynamics Office add-in connects to the Microsoft Dynamics 365 for finance and operations. And it will also log me in here. And you can see here that we actually have two tabs, one for aggregated cost entries and one for the aggregated statistical entries. So I can actually report both statistical and cost entries in Excel. And right now the system is transferring the data. The benefit of using this way of exporting data to Excel is, instead of going to the normal form of cost entries and export, is that this is actually updatable. So when you manipulate or build your insights in Excel, you don't have to redo it every single time you export. You can simply do your pivot on this sheet here of cost entries or statistical entries. And when you get new data into the system, you simply just press refresh here in this add-in, and then you get the newest data over. So what we can see now is that the data start gets updated into my two sheets, and we can see now all the data is actually exported to Excel. And we can see I have data in aggregated cost entries and aggregated statistical entries. In this little video, I will only concentrate on the cost entries. So the data is here, and I can now actually start creating my first pivot on the data to create my insight, because this is all flattened out data coming from the cost accounting. So what I want to do is I want to insert a pivot table on this first sheet. And what my achievement would be from inside is that I want to create a cost distribution sheet for my cost objects. So I will give it a name, and I will actually start defining my pivot table here. So first, I want to take the fiscal year into my filters. I only want to look at one period, so I will take the period name in here as well. We can start by filtering and saying we only want to look at 2017, and the demo data with the spring release will have data for the full 2017. So for every single month of 2017, there will be demo data available. And I can also say that I now know I want to look at the period number 6. We will also add the control name in, because I took the data out from the cost accounting ledger. So I have data for this cost accounting ledger per my control unit name. So I'll put it into my filter. Right now I want to look at all my cost objects. So I actually want not to filter on the control name to a specific control at this point. So I will keep it at all. And I will put in the version that we want to report on into my filter as well. So now I have my filters in place. And I will come back to the filters later on in the building here, how we actually select which filters to have. I want to look at all my cost objects. So I want to take the cost object dimension member name into my columns. And we can see we get them out here. We can also, I want to look at the cost entries. So the data I want to put in, the values, is the amount. So I'll put amount in here. And now I need to build my details of my structure of reporting, and I will use my cost element dimension hierarchy. I don't want to use the element level number 1, which is really just the title of the hierarchy. So I will pull in directly hierarchy level number 2. I will put in number 3. I will put in number 4. And I also want to add in number 5. I will just collapse it a bit here. We can see here that Excel uses alphanumeric sorting order. And if I want the personal cost to go above expenses, it is very simple in Excel. You just mark it, right click, and you say move, and you can say move up. And then it is going to be safe like that. So this is how you're going to see your data. So now you can actually expand it and see it. And we can do the same here. And I can also look at my expenses. So now I have my data. And one very important thing here is, because I actually stated that I wanted to look at cost objects, and I'm looking and I exported data from the cost accounting ledger and not per control unit, we can see here that all my cost objects are actually here. So I have both cost centers, and I have my two product groups, which is my orange juice for the business to business and my orange juice for consumer. So in this case, you can say it's actually a cross dimensional cost object look I have in this CDS chart here, table. So right now I'm looking at data that is in the control, and we can go down here and see that I'm looking at a lot of data. So now I want to be more specific on the data I'm looking at. So here I can go to versions. I can go to multi-select. And what I'm going to select is the specific data I want to look at. So here I will say, deselect this, all. And I will go and say, I want to look at my USP2. So I select USP2. That means all my primary cost of USP2. And here we can then see all of the overhead calculations that has been performed. And what I want to take is my period number 6. And yes, unfortunately, this is not filtered by period because this is a text string that would be nice. And this is something we want to work with for the future. But if I had, and you can see here, I have another calculation of period number 6 that I've done at 1:16 p.m. And I've done another one, a newer version, on the same date for period number 6 at 7:30 p.m. And I want to take the latest calculation. So I can actually, in Excel, sit and compare different calculations and the results of different calculations. But in this case, I want to look at the latest calculation. So I click OK. And now all my data is actually filtered to show the data of these two specific, so meaning primary and secondary costs. So primary cost of USP2. And the calculation results actually posted in that specific calculation record I selected. So again, now I have all my numbers. So what is actually up for me to do now is really to make this nice. And the way we can do that, if I make this small here, we can always use and make the numbers look nice. So first of all, I can actually filter on the data here and say we want to look at the data here as, if we go here back to home and say all of this data is in accounting numbers. We can make this one small as well. We can even hide it. Close for now. We can actually also add a template to make the design look nice. So let's take a template here. Suddenly our numbers look much nicer. So there's really two things I can use this CDS for, this cost distribution sheet for. Let me just make the columns so we can see all the numbers here. And I will just highlight here again and say, make them the cost centers here. So I know all of these are my cost centers. So I want to make them also nicer to look at. So this is about how you can actually, as a user, make your report nice for reporting to your management. For these two here, let us give and say, I know that these are not cost centers. These are cost types of my product groups, so I want to make them a different color. So when I'm looking at my report, I understand it. And we can make it the same size here. And again, imagine that you have many cost centers and product groups. So here you will actually be able to distinguish them by adding a different color on them. So in this case, and in a demo company, the cost center 094 is really a dummy cost center that the cost in the financial accounting, where financial people will post expenses of types that they don't know how to distribute. So the first check I want to do in here that I can easily do is to say, has all the expenses that has been posted to cost center 094 been redistributed, meaning that this account or this cost center needs to have a balance of zero. Because if it do not, then I know that I need to go and fix some of my allocation and distribution rules in the cost accounting module. So here I can easily validate that it is actually zeroed out. The next I can do is that I can actually look at my allocations. And here we can then see all the allocations that takes place. So here we can actually go down here, sorry. We can actually see here that we have our cost center 007. We can see that it has some primary cost coming in. We can also see that some secondary cost comes into the cost center. And we can also see that it actually allocates all of the cost out and to which cost centers it actually allocates it out to. And we can actually in the end see, because I'm looking at all my cost objects, we can actually see all of these allocations between my cost centers 007, 008, and so on, happens on the cost center allocation level. And because in my hierarchy, I distinguish between the cost centers that will then allocate to my product groups, we can actually see also here that we are allocating in, and then on these cost centers also are allocating them out, and they will actually be allocated out to my two product groups. So here I get a full picture, cross-dimensional, how my allocation calculation has been performed in the cost accounting module, and I can actually sit here in the report and trace that first, how the primary cost comes into the cost centers, how the primary cost is allocated between the cost centers, and finally, I can see how the cost centers are allocating to my product groups. So this is really the power of Excel that you get by simply exporting the data to Excel and using Power Pivot in Excel by looking at the cost entries that we can export. And again, you simply just can keep this, keep refreshing the data here, and you can just go up here and select to look at another period, and you will don't have to rebuild this UI of the reporting every single time. So this is really the benefit of Dynamics 365 for Operations and Microsoft Excel. I hope this little video was aspiration of using the open entries in Excel and the cost accounting. So thank you for listening.